After studying this module, you shall be able to know briefly about the concept of entropy, study the entropy produced due to heat flow, derive entropy produced in chemical reaction, analyze the dependence of rate of the reaction on the rate of entropy production. Now let us understand about entropy. In thermodynamics, entropy is the measure of number of microstates corresponding to specified macroscopic variables in thermodynamic system. It is the measure of degree of randomness of molecule in the macroscopic system. Second law states that the entropy of an isolated system does not decreases, while for a non-isolated system, entropy may decreases provided entropy of their environment increases by at least that amount. In natural or spontaneous processes, energy is conserved while entropy is not conserved. In such processes, entropy of the reaction increases. Entropy of the system is extensive property. The total entropy is the sum of total entropies of each individual part of system consisting of several parts. That is, if system is divided into r different part, then the total entropy is ds is equals to the sum of ds internal 1, ds internal 2, ds internal 3, and so on. Generally, ds internal k is the entropy production of the kth part, and therefore ds internal k is greater than 0 for every k part. This states that in irreversible processes, the entropy production is positive in every part, and this statement is stronger than the classical statement of second law that the entropy of an isolated system can only increases or remain unchanged. Entropy law. The change in entropy, that is, ds, is divided into two parts, which are ds external and ds internal. Ds external is flow of entropy due to interaction with exterior of the system, and ds internal is the change of entropy inside the system. Total change in entropy is given by the sum of these two entropies, and ds internal for reversible process is equals to 0. Ds internal for irreversible processes is greater than 0, but ds internal cannot be negative. Entropy production due to heat flow. According to the second law of thermodynamics, the entropy change is given by ds is equals to dq by T, where T is the temperature, dq is the heat from surrounding, and ds is the entropy change, which is an intensive property and is positive. Now consider the system consisting of two phases, 1 and 2, which are at uniform temperature T1 and T2 respectively. For the whole system consisting of these phases, the total entropy is given by ds is equals to ds1 plus ds2. Now, corresponding heat received from the surrounding by each phase is dq1 is equals to dq external 1 plus dq internal 1, and dq2 is equals to dq external 2 minus dq internal 2, where subscript ex and in stands for the external and internal. dqx1 is the heat flow from the exterior to the phase 1, and dq internal 1 is the heat flow from the internal system phase 1 to the surroundings. As the energy of the system is conserved, therefore dq internal 1 plus dq internal 2 is equals to 0. Now the corresponding entropy change of two phases is ds1 is equals to dq1 by t1 is equals to the sum of dq external 1 by t1 plus dq internal 1 by t1, whereas ds2 is equals to dq2 by t2 is equals to the difference of dq external 2 divided by t2 minus dq internal 2 divided by t2. Substituting equation 8 and equation 9 in equation 5, we get equation 10 as, where ds is equals to dq external 1 by t1 plus dq external 2 by t2 plus dq internal 1 into 1 upon t1 minus 1 upon t2. The first two terms of this equation corresponds to ds external, while the third term corresponds to ds internal. This term gives entropy production as heat is transformed from phase 2 to phase 1 due to the temperature difference T2 minus T1. Therefore, ds internal is equals to dq internal 1 into 1 upon T1 minus 1 upon T2. From this expression, we see that if the temperature of phase 2, that is T2, is greater than the temperature of phase 1, then ds internal is greater than 0, as dq internal 1 is greater than 0. Now, if T1 is greater than T2, then the quantity inside the parenthesis in the equation 11 will be less than 0, but ds internal will still be greater than 0, since dq internal 1 will also be less than 0. But if T1 is equals to T2, that is the thermal equilibrium, entropy production will be 0. The entropy production per unit time is given by sigma is equals to ds internal divided by dt is equals to dq internal by dt into 1 upon t1 minus 1 upon t2, which is greater than 0. That is, the rate of entropy production is the product of the rate of heat transfer dq internal 1 by dt and the difference of state function 1 upon t1 minus 1 upon t2. This term acts as a driving force for the heat transfer, which can be considered as flux or flow or a consequence of driving force. The total change of entropy for the whole system is given by expression 13. Now we'll see entropy production in reaction. Consider chemical reaction occurring at condition of constant temperature and pressure. Let dH be an infinitesimal small quantity of enthalpy absorbed by the surrounding at temperature T. Then infinitesimal change in entropy of the surrounding is ds external is equals to dH by T, and the infinitesimal entropy change arising from chemical reaction is ds internal. So ds is equals to the sum of ds internal plus ds external. Substituting ds external as dh by t in this equation, we get ds is equals to ds internal plus dh by t, or minus T ds internal is equals to dh minus Tds. From classical thermodynamics, we know dg is equals to dh minus Tds. Now comparing equation 16 and 17, we get ds internal is equals to minus dg by T. Thus, the rate of entropy production is given by sigma is equals to ds internal by dt is equals to minus 1 upon T into dg by dt. This states that as the Gibbs free energy increases, then the rate of entropy production decreases. Relation given by Clausius for the uncompensated heat is dq internal is equals to Tds minus dq external. dq external is the heat exchange with the surroundings and ds is the amount of entropy change of the system. Now ds is equals to ds internal plus ds external, which is equals to dq internal by T plus dq external by T, or Tds is equals to dq internal plus dq external. For the chemical reaction of an open system, that is I having the values 1, 2, 3 up to C, the thermodynamic relation is given by dg is equals to minus dt plus vdp plus summation mu I dni, in which ni is the number of moles of ith component, mu I is the chemical potential of ith component. At constant temperature and pressure condition, the above equation becomes dg is equals to summation mu I dni. From equation 19 and 24, we get sigma is equals to ds internal by dt is equals to minus 1 by T summation mu I dni by dt. Substituting for dni, we have ds internal by dt is equals to minus 1 by T d zeta by dt summation nu I into mu I, where nu is the rate of reaction and zeta is the extent of reaction. Now, as defined by D. Donders, the affinity A of a chemical reaction is A is equals to minus summation nu I into mu I. From equation 26 and 27, ds internal is equals to A upon T into d zeta, which is greater than 0, or ds internal by dt is equals to A upon T into d zeta by dt greater than 0. The rate of reaction nu in terms of extent of reaction zeta is given by nu is equals to d zeta by dt is equals to 1 upon nu I dni by dt. The molar concentration of the ith component is Ci is equals to Ni by V, where Ni is the number of moles of ith component dissolved in V liters. Differentiating above expression, we have expression 32. Let volume during the reaction remains constant, we get the expression 33. From equation 29 and 30, we get sigma is equals to ds internal by dt is equals to 1 by T into AR, which is greater than 0, or T sigma is equals to AR greater than 0. As T is positive, therefore A and R must have same sign. On comparing equation 12 and 34, we can say that the role of driving force, that is 1 upon T1 minus 1 upon T2, is played by affinity A. So, the expression for entropy production is the product of the force A and flow R, given by expression 35. For our reactions, where rho has values starting from 1 to 3 up to R, occurring simultaneously, the equation can be extended to dS internal is equals to 1 by T summation A rho d zeta rho greater than 0, where A rho is the affinity of rhoth reaction. It is given by A rho is equals to minus summation nu I rho into mu I. But at equilibrium, all affinities are 0, that is A1 is equals to A2 is equals to A rho is equals to 0. The entropy production per unit time is now given by the expression, which is dS internal by dt is equals to 1 by t summation A rho into R rho, which is greater than 0. That is, the entropy production per unit time is the sum of entropy production due to various reactions. The entropy production of all simultaneous reaction is positive. If in a system where two reactions are occurring simultaneously such that A1R1 is less than 0 and A2R2 is greater than 0, and the sum of these two terms is A1R1 plus A2R2 is greater than 0, then both these two reactions are said to be coupled reactions. Now let us summarize. Entropy is a measure of degree of randomness of molecule in the macroscopic system. The total entropy of the system is the sum of entropies of the individual part of the system. The total change in entropy is the sum of two components, dS is equals to dS internal plus dS external, where dS internal is a change in entropy inside the system and dS external is a flow of entropy due to the interaction with the exterior of the system. The change in entropy in terms of heat exchange from the surroundings according to second law of thermodynamics is given by the expression dS is equals to dQ by T, where dQ is the amount of heat exchange from the surrounding at temperature T. The total change in entropy due to the heat flow from the surrounding is given by sigma is equals to dS internal by dT is equals to dQ internal by dT into 1 upon T1 minus 1 upon T2, where dQ internal by dT is the rate of heat transfer and 1 upon T1 minus 1 upon T2 is the difference between the state function which is acting as a driving force for the heat transfer. The entropy produced due to chemical reaction which is occurring at constant temperature and pressure condition is given by dS internal by dT is equals to 1 by T summation A rho into R rho, in which A rho stands for the affinity of the rhoth reaction having nu rho as the rate of reaction at temperature T.